Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com and welcome back to the channel. Now in this video, we are going to talk about MVVM, and that is Model View, View Model, and we are going to dive into this pattern and teach you how you can use it and how you can benefit it from it in your code using Swift. Okay, so let's dive in. Great. Now let's take a look at what we are going to achieve here, and then we are going to talk about the MVVM pattern. So let's start off with that, the testing easy MVVM project, and you can see that here we have a reset and a fetch button. Well, we are going to talk about that in the next episode of our MVVM let's call it playlist or series. For now, we are going to see that we are going to have an Alex, 36, and that is the age of our user, and the background color of this view controller, and that is a white. Now, that is what we are going to build out today. Not really exciting, but we are going to use MVVM to achieve this. Okay, let's just jump right into the code. Now, go ahead and take a look at the link down below and you will find the resources. You will be taken to my YouTube channel resources page where you will find the link to the GitHub repository, and it is called Easy MVVM. And once you download it or clone it, you will be shown this Easy MVVM project, and you will find that there aren't any pod files or pods in your project, so you need to install them. Well, we already have our pod file ready, so what you need to do is type in terminal, well, open it up, let's make this a little bigger, and type in cd and the space, and just simply drag and drop the root folder of your project there and hit return. Now we are inside the root folder of our project. Now all you need to do is type in pod update and hit return. Now this will take a while, it will update the pods for you, but you will be able, and I won't do this now, you will be able to use all of the pods that we have here, and we have only one pod, and that is time constraint, to constrain all of the views. Now again, as usual, if you don't know what time constraint is and how it works, go ahead and take a look at the playlist on my channel to see how that works. Okay, so let's take a look at what we have here. We have our app delegate, and it basically has this root view controller added to the navigation controller, and that navigation controller is added to the Windows root view controller. Yeah, pretty boring stuff if you ask me, but that's what it is. So in the root view controller, we have all of this setup. We have a label, activity indicator. We will talk about that later on. We set up our navigation, we add our selectors to our navigation buttons, and we set up our views, basically adding the labor and activity indicator and constraining it with the help of tiny constraints. Here we have our dispatch queue helper and our user helper. We won't talk about the dispatch queue helper in this video, but we will use it in the next one. Now, if you don't know what dispatch queue helper is, go ahead and take a look at the other video that I have created about dispatch queue helper. Believe me, it helps a lot in threading and, let's say, going to background and going back to the main thread and so on. What we will use is this user Swift file. And here we have a basic model of our user. It is a struct, and it has a name, age, and background, and it initializes appropriately with the name, age, and background color of, it will be the background color of our view controller. Okay, so what do we want to achieve here? Well, in the root view controller, we want to have the name and age in the navigation items title, and we want to set the background color of our view controller, because if we just build and run now, we will not see any of those. Let's just wait for that, and you can see the background color is in existence, so it is black. We don't have the name of our user. Think of it like this is the view controller of the user. We don't have the name of the user and the age. Okay, so let's stop that and let's try to implement it the not MVVM, the model view, view model way. And first of all, what we would do is in the setup views, we would set the background color. So view dot background color equals white. Okay, and that sets the background color to be white. Now, what we want to have here is, let's say we want to set the inside the setup navigation, we want to set the title of our navigation item. So navigation item dot title equals and Alex and 36. Okay, let's build and run and see how that looks. Okay, it is pretty familiar. It's just what we did or shown in the previous app, in the test app, Alex 36 and the background color is white. Well, that was easy. Well, what if we want to have another user and another user or limited amounts of users and they would need to have their name and age and their preferred background color added to this view controller? Well, because this is hard-coded, let me just stop this. Well, because this is hard-coded, we wouldn't be allowed to change this, okay? So what we need here is separate the view controller from the logic of it, from the model. And that is where the view model comes right in. Okay, so what we need to do is let me just comment out. We are not going to delete it. Let us just comment out so you can see what we have changed. We are going to create a view model. So let's create a new file here and Swift file, and it will be called root view model. Okay, so the view model of our root view controller. So let's hit create there and let's create a new class here and it will be named root view model and it will not have any superclass and we are going to initialize it. So first of all, let's type in init, just a simple initializer here. Great, pretty straightforward, nothing fancy, just a simple root view model. Let me just drag this up here. Okay, now inside the root view controller, what we want to add to this root view model is this data, Alex and 36 and the white background color. Now we could create for the root view model those properties like the name, age and background color, but we and initialize it accordingly, but we are going to use this user model instead because it's much more convenient. And how to do that? So first of all, we need to add our user here. So let's have a property that is let user and it will be of type user. Okay, that is pretty straightforward, but now we need to initialize our root view controller with this user. So user and user, and of course we need to add self.user equals user, so our user property gets the user that we initialized our root view controller with. Great, pretty straightforward. Okay, let's go to our root view controller and now we need to create our view model, and that is pretty easy because we want to, let's call this a variable and view model, and it will be of type root view model. Okay. Now that we do have our view model, we want to initialize it with a user. So to do that, we are going to use this in the view did load. So let's create our user first. let user equals user, and it will have a name of Alex, the age of 36, and the background color, let's go with white for now. And now we want to create our view model, and let's set our view model equals to root view model. Let's just hit command B here so we get our completions correctly. Here we go, user and user. Great. Now, let's hit command B so this error would go away. Build has succeeded. Okay, now we have initialized our view model with this user. And what that means is that our root view model now has a user property that is set when we initialized it. Now we need to know some things about this user. How do we actually get that user in our view controller? Well, once we set our view model, we can access the view model's properties. And that is pretty straightforward. Did set. And now that we have set our view model, we can basically access our view model's user. And inside there, we can have our age, name, and background. Great. So, first of all, let's set the background of our view controller. So, view.backgroundColor equals viewModel.user.backgroundColor. So, let's see if this really worked. And we should see the white background color of our view controller. Not just, not yet the name or the age, but the white background color. Now, let's see if this really, really worked. Like, let's change this to purple. Let's hit Command R again. There we go. The background color is purple. Great. Let's change that back with Command Z. And finally, let's add our navigation item's title to be our view model's user name and age. So, and that is it. Let's hit Command B or the play button in Xcode. And you can see that in the navigation item, there is a title and it is our user's username and age, and the background color is white. Now, that is it for the basic MVVM. Again, we have created a root view model that we initialized with our user model, and we have, of course, we do have our property of user in the root view model. And when we did set the view model, we handle all of the graphics, like the background color, setting the title. That is a good thing because we separate the view controller from basically the view model actions. And then we can simply set the user to be of other type. Whenever we instantiate the view controller, we just set the user. We set the name, age, and background color, whatever we would like, and then the view model takes care of everything. Now, I hope you enjoyed this video. Now, in the next video, we are going to talk about model view, view model with delegates, and that is because we need to have some sort of resetting, fetching, and so on. Now, the view model acts only when it is set, but we do want to have these fetches. Let's say we want to fetch from a server something and then it returns and we want to modify the contents of our view controller. Well, that is where delegates come in handy, and go ahead and take a look at the delegates video. It is the previous video in this list. Go ahead and take a look at that if you don't know how to use delegates. But we will be talking about MVVM model view model with delegates to handle this problem. Now, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and hit that notification bell to get notified of new videos. Now it is your turn. Go ahead and build out your own MVVM projects with a view controller, or this could be a cell too. Okay, now go ahead, and if you do have some questions, comment down below. I will be eager to answer them all. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.